What does teaching and learning look like in internationals, network schools? In a traditional classroom, you'll see the teacher in the front of the room talking, and the students, the ones in the front row raising their hand and the ones in the back row with their heads down, quite honestly, in high school, if we think back on our own high school experience. In internationals network, you'll walk into a classroom and you'll recognize an internationals network classroom. You'll see kids sitting at tables. You'll see them working together. You'll see them speaking English, all different varieties of English together. You'll hear home languages. You'll hear a variety of different languages. You'll see kids working on projects, engaged. You'll not always recognize who's the teacher in the room because the teacher is moving around from table to table. You'll see hands-on activities. You'll see student work all over the walls. You'll see students up in the classroom presenting in English and showing their work and supporting each other as peer tutors in their home language and in English. You'll go into rooms where teachers are meeting in teams across disciplines and aligning their instruction. You'll talk to the college advisor who is meeting not just with students in AP classes, but with every single student, regardless of the skills that they came into ninth grade with, and encouraging that student to prepare for a viable post-secondary pathway, be it starting in community college or going to a four-year elite school. You'll see student government in action. You'll see family events where parents come to the school and maybe host a family night or take part in family math night with their kids. You'll see internships, kids going off on internships to do real-life experiences and work in the community to improve their English.
At the International High School for Health Sciences, teaching and learning puts students in authentic, real-world situations where they have to work together as a team to solve some problems from their community. In our school, teaching is through projects. So students collaborate working together to do something that they couldn't do by themselves. The thing that makes the International High School for Health Sciences a little bit different in New York City is the specific career focus that we have on healthcare occupations. So our students all have an opportunity to take a series of connected classes that help expose them to a career. It's not necessarily the case that all of them are going to pursue pharmacy or medicine or nursing after they get out of high school, but we think that by having a sustained focus on what it takes to get into a particular career, what are the opportunities and advantages of getting that education and pursuing those goals after high school, that it motivates students to make a connection between the purpose of what they're doing from grade 9 to 12 and where they're going to go after their time with us is over.
Okay, at Flushing International High School, we follow the internationals model using the HELLO core principles. So teaching and learning follows those principles. The letter H represents heterogeneity, diversity in curriculum, representing all learners, E for experiential learning, hands-on, project-based learning, L for localized autonomy, so we encourage our teachers and our students to own their work, to be responsible for the curriculum, for resources, for their own learning. Because we are an ESL, an inclusive community, all our classes are basically ESL classes. So we encourage the integration of language and content. So whether you're a math teacher, a science, an English, or a history teacher, you're teaching your content through language. You're teaching language through your content. And then the O for HELLO represents one learning for all. So whatever we engage our students with, we also try to do it for ourselves and among ourselves. For experiential learning, we are a project-based school, so a lot of our learning, all of our learning is hands-on. An example of that would be a project that I recently did, which was based on Malala. She was a student, an activist in Pakistan. She was about 15 years old, and she was shot because she was going to school, and the Taliban in her area, they were against girls going to school. So I used that text as the base for a project where students were able to debate issues surrounding discrimination against women and girls. I based it in a United Nations format, so it was a type of a simulation, a model United Nations, and at the end of it, the goal was that they would be able to express themselves, express views that are their own views, express views in a way that they could use those skills when they have graduated from our school. For autonomy, again, we focus a lot on student voice and helping students to advocate for themselves, which is something that we also do as teachers. For language and content integration, of course, the content would be being able to justify a choice that they've made, being able to analyze different points of view, and doing so through the skills of language, speaking, reading, listening, and writing. And of course, one model for all, whatever is practiced within our school, is also developed in my classroom. So things like being able to provide feedback to each other in a way that's constructive and respectful. So I think those are some key ways that those core principles are expressed in my classroom.